neutral side action, and we're just about set to kick off. Before we head down to the field for the coin toss, we'd like to remind you this game is brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coke taste, zero calories. Enjoy everything. Both teams are lining up for the kickoff, and we're just about set to get this one underway. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. He's to the 20, and down he goes at the 20. So here comes the offense taking the field for the first time today. Runs it left for a decent game. That's a deep six of the play. That brings him second and five. He's tackled at the 35-yard line.
You like to see a team having success like this running the football. It can really open up things for the offense.
And he's tackled after positive yardage. Run right side. Makes it to the 47.
Good solid running right there. Getting past the defensive lineman and into the secondary before he could be stopped.
He's taken down at about the 49. Quickly, and that was almost picked.
That was a nice play. Anything you can do without being penalized to prevent the offense from moving forward is always a plus.
Third down, and they need to get it inside the 43. And he's tackled at about the 41.
Man, that's tough for this defense. They came so close to stopping the conversion, but they'll have to stay out there again now.
Run up the middle. And down he goes, around the 15-yard line.
They need his disruptive presence back there in the secondary. He's got to learn to be a little bit more disciplined with his judgments.
He laterals the ball. Room around the corner. Brought down around the 1 yard line. Touchdown, Cyclones. Converts the extra point. So an 11 play, 78-yard drive, and it's good for 7 points. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He sends this one deep. He's to the 20, and he's taken down at the 22-yard line. The quarterback brings his troops out onto the field for the first drive of the game. It's caught. First down, and he's out of bounds. A good play fake that time.
Here, the play action was key. It held the linebackers there by the fake by the running back, and the running back did a very nice job of carrying out his fake.
From their own 39-yard line, first down. Watch 20, check 20. Hey, Mike 52. decent pickup.
Gain of 7 yards. That'll bring up second and three.
Nice run up the middle. Pretty good gain on the play by the halfback.
Good play here. Getting a new set of downs and keeping the run an integral part of this offense.
First and 10. Ball on the 49. Tackle made at the 46. To his receiver. Tackle at about the 29-yard line. From the 29-yard line, first down. Brought down immediately.
Number 7 on the tackle at the 24-yard line. That brings up second and 5.
It's third down and 5 to go. Ball on the 24-yard line. He's got it with room to run. They'll bring him down at about the 11. This is the ninth play of this drive. Got the corner. And he's taken down at the 8-yard line. It's second down, 7 to go. Ball on the 8-yard line. On the ground with the tailback. And they make the stop around the 11-yard line.
So give the defense all the credit here. Dad, that one snuffed out from the start. It could have been an even bigger loss.
And this is the 11th play of the current drive. Made the catch, but he's knocked out before he gets back to the line of scrimmage. They'll line up for the field goal, and this is nothing more than a chip shot. The kick is up, and it sails through the uprights.
And you got to think they're pretty happy with holding them to a field goal right there.
They line up to kick this one away. And he got all of this one. Great kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
I think this defense right now needs somebody to try to lift up their spirits. They seem to really be just out there kind of going through the motions. And I think the last time they were out there when they gave up such a long drive has had an impact and an effect negatively on the psyche of this defense.
Iowa State is up 4. Third and 8, ball on the 27. Stays in bounds to make a nice catch. That makes quick throw. He's tackled around the 41-yard line. So at the end of one, the Cyclones in front, 7-3. Set to resume action here in the second quarter, and we've got a tight ball game.
I love the toughness here by this quarterback, sitting in until the last second, trying to make a play downfield, only to have this defense get to him. He's got to do a better job maybe feeling things out a little bit, but at least he has the awareness and a toughness to sit in that pocket.
And he's level at the 34. After the sack, it's now fourth and long. Booming kick. He's tackled at the 25. With one quarter down, I really haven't seen too much separation between these two squads. Might be neck and neck the whole way. After a decent run up the gut.
That makes it second and six.
Second down and six. Ball on their own 29. And he carries the ball for a nice gain.
That's good for a gain of 5 yards. That'll bring up third and two.
And they get nice yardage on that run. From their own 40-yard line, it's first down. He fights forward to about the 43.
Makes it second and six.
Man left. Four down. My 52.
Looking for the corner. Gets out to around the 48.
That's a gain of 9
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 48-yard line. Makes it to the 37.
You know that saying, get your keys out, because we're on a drive? This offense right now is on a drive. I mean, this is their third first down. They're doing just about anything they want, and they're really starting to wear the psyche of this defense down.
The halfback picks up a yard. From the 36-yard line, second down. He gets to about the 27-yard line. It's the ninth play of the drive. Picks up another first down.
Well, this really works on a defense's psyche. You can see the guys on defense right now just trying to catch their wind. Once again, they had a chance to bring this drive to a halt, but were unable to do it. The offense really seems to be clicking right now.
Up the middle for a nice gain. They get about 6 yards on the option to the halfback. Here's the 11th play of the drive.
Go 4, green 9.
He's taken down at the 10-yard line. The pass is complete for 7 yards, and that'll be a first down.
Nice protection, a good pass, and even a better catch. You can't ask for much more than that.
And the quarterback didn't waste any time getting rid of that one. He took the snap, and he threw it right out there on play action. Zips it to his receiver. Touchdown. So the kicker will line up here and try to give his team a 3-point lead with this extra point. He makes the PAT. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. Nice kick, plenty of distance. He's to the 20, and he's tackled at the 24. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. He goes out of bounds at the 27. It's second and 8. Ball on their own 27. There's a strike complete. Makes the grab and steps out right away. From their own 49-yard line, first down. And he's tackled around the 40-yard line.
This guy has that innate ability to get just enough distance from a defender to make a completion possible. You don't see it from every receiver, but this guy's got it.
Caught with room to work. He steps out to 39-yard line.
Gain of 1 yard. That brings up second and 9.
From the 39-yard line, it's second down. Here's the halfback on the screen. And down he goes at the 36. Throw, and he's got his receiver again, and he shoved out of bounds at the 27-yard line. From the 27-yard line, first down. Hit as he threw, and he completes it. Brought down right around the 16-yard line. Iowa State's going to use their first time out of the half here. We're at play number 9 of this current drive. They run it left. And they get him in the backfield for a loss. So the halfback loses about 2 on the run. From the 18-yard line, it's second down. Hand off, and he's met immediately. Out of bounds at the 16-yard line. Iowa State can tie it up here with this kick. He gets it up, and the field goal is good. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He just drills this one. He's to the 20. Brought down at the 27. Right now, this game's got all the makings of maybe being a nail biter.
Yeah, this game just feels like it's going to go well into the second half, probably into the fourth quarter. You almost have a feel that maybe one of the defenses may have to score a touchdown to be able to win this game.
So it's time to see this offense go to work again.
This defense couldn't stop them from moving the ball and inevitably finding the end zone.
quickly. Now he's scrambling. He's to the 40. Decides to slide.
It's always a snap decision when you decide to tuck it and run. On that play, it was definitely the right move as he got the first down after a nice game.
And we'll probably see how far he can throw it, as it should be the last play before the half. What a play, and that'll set up a first and goal. So we've played two quarters and a 10-10 tie in this game.
We played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show, presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game. There is nothing, and I mean nothing, that is more important than turnovers. Now, so far, neither defense has been able to force one in this game, but you never know when that opportunity is going to come up.
No, and people look at turnovers and they assume that it's luck a lot of times, but a lot of times it's preparation. It's being able to know that when certain teams line up, like South Carolina back in 2002, in a certain formation where it's Tucson open stud, and they got three receivers to my side, and I know it's a rollout pass. As a defensive end, I widened my stance a little bit, came upfield, hit the quarterback as he was throwing it. Next thing you know, the ref signals his hands up in the air, and you get 6 points for it. So you can definitely be prepared, and that's how you force those turnovers.
David and I will be keeping an eye on your game and everything else going on in the country here in our palatial and comfortable surroundings in the studio. The best seat in the house belongs to Brad Nessler and Kirk Herbstreit.
All right, Reese and David, thanks, guys. Second half action just about ready to start here. Sends it sailing downfield. He's to the 20. Tackle at the 26. You don't want to squander any possessions, but maybe now's the right time to dip into your bag of tricks a little. Think about some gadget plays to catch the defense napping. Complete. He's got room. Tackle made around the 34-yard line.
What impresses me so much is the guy's vision. He read the coverage perfectly to find his man for good yardage.
It's second down now, and they're just a few feet away from that first down marker. Tackle around the 35-yard line. Makes it out to about the 43. First down, 10 to go. Ball on their own 43. And he just gets rid of it.
Brad, I just think this quarterback's got to do a much better job of being able to read that defense and make quicker decisions. And especially when the defense starts to get pressure, you've got to either get rid of that football or check it down or take off and run with it.
To the right and tackle immediately. And so it's another third down upcoming here. Bring him down at the 4. So now it's first and goal after the big pass play. Fires quick. Tipped.
I don't think the quarterback read the zone properly. The linebacker was in a great spot to make a play on the ball.
Here's the 8th play of the series.
Number 52. 52. 52. 52. 52. 52. he's taken down.
Right around the 4-yard line.
No gain. That makes it third and goal.
So here we go. It's third and goal from the 3-yard line. They put everyone up on the line. And they make the stop at the 1-yard line. A couple, maybe 3 yards on that run. Touchdown, MSU.
This kid is a really reliable weapon. You definitely want the football in his hands near the end zone, and he showed you why right there.
He splits the uprights with the extra point. Looks like they're ready for the kick. He really got a hold of that kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. He gets to about the 34-yard line. Complete across the middle. He's tackled at about the 41. Run right and hit the backfield. And he was pretty much stuffed on that run.
You know what? That was just a nice job by the defense in stopping him before he could get going and build up momentum.
It's second and 12. Ball on the 43-yard line. He guns it to the left. Got it. Complete. He's out of bounds. He's into the open field. Nice run to the left there. Up the middle. Big play there, and now they're looking at first and goal.
Very well-designed play that time to give them a first down. Linemen executed their blocks nicely, and it went for a good game.
Kirk, we got a player down, obviously in some pain. First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line. They come out in a goal line set. And he tackles him hard at the 3. This is the 10th play of this drive. The Cyclones had one of their key players go down earlier, but it looks like he might be able to get back in the lineup. Quick strike, tight end, and that's a touchdown. The extra point to tie this game up. And he adds the extra point. A 10-play, 73-yard drive, and they come away with a touchdown.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass. Just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
This game is all tied up at 17. And he got all of this one. Great kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Both teams have really answered the bell here in the third quarter, Kirk.
Well, exciting to see what these offenses have been able to do here. To be able to come out and score in your first drive tells you a lot about what they did during the half.
Time's getting a little bit tighter now. You got to make every possession count. Makes it out to about the 33.
That's a deep hit on the play. That makes it second and two.
So it's second down and about 2 yards to go. Down after a nice run up the middle. They'll go ground. Gets to about the 41-yard line.
Gain 2 yards. That makes it second and eight.
From their own 41-yard line. Second down. So at the end of three, good game here, 17-17.
That'll bring up third and eight.
All right, we're just about set to start action here again in the fourth quarter. We might look back on this game when it's all over and say that's the point where they won the football game with that stop. They get this one off and it's a beauty. He fields a punt at the 20. He's taken down at the 27-yard line. And you know, it's basically like we're starting from zero here in a one-quarter game now. Every possession is vital. He's taken down right around the 40. Tackled around the 44-yard line. Throws complete. He's got space to work. There's a very impressive open field tackle. Carries the ball for a nice game. He wants it all going long. Oh, he had the pick and he dropped it.
You never know what will happen when the ball ricochets like that. Good effort by the defender.
From the 45-yard line, second down. So an empty backfield with five wide receivers.
Number 13 was the intended receiver on the way. That brings us third and 10.
Three down. Let's go.
Mike, 53.
It's broken up.
That was a nice play. Anything you can do without being penalized to prevent the offense from moving forward is always a plus.
The punter is going to try to pin them deep in their own territory with a good punt here. This one will go into the end zone, and they'll bring it out to the 20. You've got to be aware that capitalizing on this drive is crucial. You want to take the pressure off you and put it on your opponent. He fights forward to about the 23. From their own 23-yard line, second down. And down he goes, right around the 32-yard line. Just under three to go in regulation. He makes it to the 32-yard line.
Well, the defensive line got such a good push up front that there was no one on the offense to account for the linebacker. And he got through almost untouched.
Man left, man left.
From their own 32-yard line, it's second down. Here's the halfback, and he's brought down hard behind the line. And he shoved out of bounds at the 49-yard line. From their own 49-yard line, it's first down. In the shotgun and five wideouts. Finds his receiver, and that's a first down, and he's tackled right away. Halfback's got it on the quick throw. He's at the 30. He's at the 20. He gets hit out of bounds at the 16. From the 16-yard line, first down. Less than 2 minutes in the fourth quarter. The 10, brought down just outside the goal line. This is the ninth play of this drive. The play clock's at double zero. They just took too long.
Delay of game. Offense.
Michigan State up six. He makes the PAT. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. Nice kick, plenty of distance. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. It's been a good one so far today. Let's see what happens here.
Every smart offensive coordinator here will tell his quarterback to work the play clock down to 1 second before every snap. You want to work the clock as much as you want to try to move the football. It's you against the clock trying to secure the win here.
Throws it in a hurry. He's knocked out of bounds. Right around the 48-yard line. From their own 48-yard line. First down. Under pressure.
It's a bad play overall by the offense. The quarterback's doing everything he can to be able to make the play work and try to execute. The problem is the offensive line did not do a good job protecting him. They're very fortunate that ball wasn't intercepted. From the right direction, and it seemed to confuse the offense.
And if they don't convert here, then the game is over. Wow, you just gotta love it for this defense. They come up with the stop of the ball game and maybe the season. Not much of a problem getting the ball in the end zone on their last drive as this quarterback just picked apart the defense.
As long as this quarterback has time to throw, then you can guarantee that he'll find the open man.
Gains his way to the 29-yard line.
I like how efficient the offense looked on that play. Everybody knew their assignment, and it all came together for a nice run.
Under a minute left in the game. He gets out to about the 21-yard line. A nice job by the offensive line, and they pick up a gain of eight. It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. And this should be a kneel down as they just try to kill the clock. The offense lining up in a victory formation, and he takes a knee. Tackle after a decent run up the gut. And that's a first down.
First down, and now they have an opportunity to run some more time off the clock.
Going to do it for this one. Our final score, 24-17, Michigan State. That's going to do it for this presentation of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, this is Brad Nessler saying goodbye.